Welcome to Elite Expert Insider Podcast, where we will inspire, motivate, and educate entrepreneurs, innovators, and growth seekers. Brought to you by Elite Online Publishing, making the best and brightest in the industry number one best-selling authors. 80% of people say they want to write a book. We're assuming that's the same for you. If so, contact us at www.eliteonlinepublishing.com and make your book a reality. Hi, Melanie Johnson here, along with Jen Foster. How are you doing, Jen?
Hey, it's a great day.
It is a great day, especially if you want to make your business explode. All right, we've been using this tool for a while now, and it has been amazing. It has to do with LinkedIn. That's your little clue here. We're with Scott Adam Kaveny, and he is the author of the new book that we published, Elite Online Publishing, Grow Your Business Massively and Easily with Integrity Using LinkedIn Automation. So before we get started and dive into this topic, we want you to subscribe to our podcast. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and leave us a review. We'd love to hear from you. And if you want us to talk about or interview someone specific, let us know who that is. We'd be happy to do that. Let us know if you want more of a certain topic so we can dive deeper into that. And we also want to talk about Elite Online Publishing, who just published this awesome book for Scott. He became an international bestseller in 6 categories in the US and Canada. Congratulations, Scott. Hank, thanks for being here, and tell us, you're going to tell us how to crush it on LinkedIn.
Yes. Thank you for that introduction, Melanie. So I have started this business in May 20 of 18. So the idea just came, and I knew nothing about LinkedIn back then. I had 574 connections and inspiration. I mean, I'm very also intuitive as well. So I've been really been paying attention to the ideas that were flowing to me. And one, I was looking for a way to switch careers and be able to serve more people. And secondly, I've always been interested in the internet marketing and developing your online presence. And so as these ideas came through, one day when I was going to practice, you know, during training, basically it became this idea to where not only I can grow my connections, but I can also be able to generate these leads and also eventually revenue, because it's something that a lot of people need in growing their business if they're small to medium sized. And I also found out that as I was going through more of the LinkedIn platform, that you could also geo-target and find people specifically to what your needs are for business. So it started growing, and I went from 574 people on LinkedIn to over 37,000 right now on LinkedIn.
Wow.
One account's almost maxed out. The other one is up to about 8,000. So there's quite a bit of there's quite a bit of people that I'm connected with that are high powered CEOs. Grant Cardone came up to me and wanted to know a little bit more what my system was. Right now I'm maxed out with the amount of people that I can help out with LinkedIn automation, because I've realized that instead of sharing the secret sauce, I'm actually giving them the service so they can experience the sales for themselves. And then from there, be able to renegotiate retainers and things like that. So
awesome.
That's
what
I'm currently
at right now. Let's talk a little bit about connections on LinkedIn. So when I first started on LinkedIn, I would just connect with whoever and whatever and just kind of say yes to people, even if I hadn't met them before. And then one time I had a meeting with someone who said, you know, I'd really love to get introductions to some of your connections on LinkedIn. And I thought, well, I probably only know like maybe a third of the people that I actually, you know, that are actually on my connections. And so I couldn't really give him that resource. And so I didn't know for sure, you know, what is the protocol? Do you connect with anyone? Do you connect with everyone? Do you target specific people like you just said? Because of course, it's natural when you're at an event to say, hey, I'll connect with you on LinkedIn, and you know, get the business card and then find them on LinkedIn. So that works as well. But tell us a little bit about the targeting and diving into like your niche and finding the people on LinkedIn that would be a value, you a value to them and them a value to you. So talk about that a little.
Well, first of all, you want to have a little bit of a connection base. So if you have more than 10 people, then that's great. You have to start somewhere. So in other words, when you start a LinkedIn account, you have to network with people that perhaps maybe are close to you or in your through your email list, or basically how LinkedIn detects. Once you have 10 people connected, then you can actually expand your network through second degree. That second degree actually is one of the filters that you would use to identify your target market. So once you have your second degree, then you also want to target people with specific keywords in their title, as well as different cities that you're interested in and what you want to target people that may be interested in what you have to offer, and then also industries. So those are the three main things that I look at. So it's the degree, which is always second. We never go third. There's industries, and then there's the keywords.
Awesome.
And then basically from there, you would grow your network. I mean, just one day at a time.
Right. And you mentioned a couple big names in earlier that are great in marketing. And I always say, you know, you're always 2 to 3 connections away from knowing the person that you're looking to seek, you know, the person you're seeking to talk to. So that's exactly what LinkedIn can help you do. So tell us a little bit about, you know, what your services are and how you can help someone. And let's maybe dive into the case studies that you've worked with Elite Online Publishing with that as well.
Oh, for sure. So the people that I've actually, I want to help in that are people that have a good sales process. I want to make sure that the people that I'm matching up with have a good sales process, that are able to process those leads that come to them. I'm really good at being able to narrow those down for other people. So basically for me to provide this as a service, basically I'm providing these leads to these people. And I do it on my end, and I charge more for people that actually want to learn this by, you know, on their own and for their own company.
So kind of like when we did it, I love it. It's you send out, just to break it down how this works for anybody out there. So before, I would send personal messages to people. I would scout out, you know, do the search bar. Okay, I'm looking for CEOs of companies. And then it would pull up from my network. And then I'd have to copy and paste messages in there to send to them. So what Todd's software is doing is that you're putting the category of who you want to reach out to, you put the message in there, and then it automatically, the system runs 24/7, and it does it in a time so LinkedIn doesn't flag you that, hey, you sent too many here, you did that. So I wouldn't just want to share the results of that. What happens is, without me even really having to do any labor or hiring a VA to do this, I open my message box in the morning and I've got 15, 20 messages. Some say, hey, thanks, great for connecting, or, you know, seeing your message, no thanks, or, hey, here's what I do, or they're like, wow, I would want to learn more. And for us, it's like, hey, I've got a friend of mine that's publishing a book, or I'm in a similar business, I think we can help each other. So we were targeting some strategic partners, so we got strategic partners out of it this time, and some people who wanted to be clients of ours. So now on the second phase, we were answering manually. So I was going back and making it more personal based on what their response was. But now I just did it for 1 week. And I want to say I got in 1 week, I probably had 20 messages that were valuable messages that I could follow up in and got appointments with. That's a lot.
That's really awesome.
20 new leads in a week. And I really spent maybe an hour getting it all set up and doing it, because it was the first time for me. So the second time probably doesn't spend as, you don't have to do it as much.
Mm-hmm.
So,
oh yeah.
So tell us now, you do it several ways. Either you say it's a done for you service, and I don't want to sound too salesy here to people, but just so you know, for your business, it's a way to explode your business using LinkedIn. Gary Vee has been talking about using LinkedIn. It's kind of the sleeper thing. But you know, so walk us through, like, what do you think is best for a client to do? Should they be doing it themselves? Should they be having you do it for them? What's an easiest way?
It depends on the client. So it depends on the client. Mostly I do it for them because, especially now when people are busy and they may not have a marketing team or don't understand the automation process. I mean, I give them a sample. I have a demo video that actually explains the how the plugin works as a Google plugin. Mm-hmm. But for mostly I actually help people with their leads and do the work for them. And, you know, you made a good point about these messages, because not only you can geo-target and find the people that they need, but also find a message that suits them the best and makes them feel like you're talking to them. And we want to make sure that we are talking to them, but the mundane stuff, we want to leave that to automation.
Yeah,
so let's I'm a firm believer in high tech and high touch for sure.
Yeah, the high touch and the integrity, I think, is the key part. So having that communication, because I don't know about you, but I get at least, I don't know, 5 or 10 messages a week that are just, I feel like it's just spam, spam, spam. Like I connect with someone and instantly I have a message that's like more than this long. You know, I mean, it's a good 3 paragraphs with 4 links or, you know, what link to their website or work with me now and all these spammy type messages, which I just skip over them. I don't even want to reply. Some of them I don't even read because they're too long. And so that's where you really got to do the beta testing and see what works with your niche. What do they like reading? Do they like having the long email or the long email? It's not an email, it's supposed to be a message, right?
Yeah, so that's the confusion.
That's the confusion.
Some people are sending... Yeah, they're sending email messages in Messenger or LinkedIn message. So you're
And it should be a message. So, you know, for me, when we did the first, there's 2 ways to use the software, the artificial intelligence. And one way is connecting with new leads and finding your niche and seeking out those people, but the and messaging them, you know, to get them to connect with you. But the first one that we did was targeting my first connection leads, so people that I've already connected to, and simply asking them if they're interested in our service and letting them know what I do in a simple way. And do you know anyone who is looking for this, right? And looking for your service or your thing that you're providing the value. And then simply asking them, you know, hey, what's the best way to contact you? So for me saying that, which was, you know, what Scott advised me to do, then I would get, sometimes I wouldn't get the email right away. Sometimes they'd ask me questions about, you know, what exactly I do. And then eventually they would say, oh yeah, here's my email. Or a few times they said, you know, I'm not looking to do that right now. I'm not looking for your service right now, but I would be interested in the future. So let me give you my email. And I would say, oh, well, I can put you on our newsletter list. And so I got a lot of leads that went onto our newsletter. So every week they're going to be getting an email from us so that maybe in 6 months or 3 months, they're going to reach back out if they do want our service. So there was a lot of connecting going on, not just, you know, selling stuff, but also making new connections and getting people who maybe will use us in the future.
Yep, exactly. It's all about cultivation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, and I was just going to say the first person we closed actually from this, he was actually a client that we had talked to, not a client, but a person we had talked to last year. But he was a connection on my LinkedIn. So with that email or that message, sending it to him reminded him, oh yeah, I do want to talk to them. I tried to talk to them last year and for whatever reason, we didn't follow up or he didn't follow up or whatever reason, we didn't get the proposal to him. So once I got his email and got the proposal, he had his book ready and we had a client to help with get his book published. So it was awesome.
Yep. Well, the key with all this is to keep your messages short and to keep the messages very casual because so many people, they put, hey, first name, and that gets pretty old. Just that part.
Yeah.
And then basically people put in links that actually create more of a spam sort of feel. So I totally advise people to not do that and to actually keep it real short and sweet and as if you're talking to a very close friend.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So how important is it to have a lot of connections on LinkedIn and grow your base on there?
It's very important because you're developing reputation. And the more integrous you are with following up with people and talking to them and getting to know them and providing them value, then basically they will not only, you know, be interested in what you have to say, but also tell other people that they know in hey, come check this person's app, this person's product out or whatever. Mm-hmm. It sounds like that he did a great job with how he's presenting himself or herself.
So you've got growing your network's really important. Blow it up as big as you can. And then once you have it, like, so I had grown mine from 3,000 to 10,000 just manually doing that. And but then it's like, well, I'm not communicating with them, you know, except for our articles and our posts. So how often should we be communicating with our base?
I would say once a week.
Okay.
And we want to keep it limited because I know we're limited with time. All of us are. So what I suggest is finding a group of targeted people that you want to talk to. And then basically from that targeted group, you would follow up with those people using the messaging system that I provided.
And so send them a message once a week.
Once a week, yeah.
Mm-hmm. A different message.
It wouldn't be for your whole list of, like, it wouldn't be for my whole list of 10,000. It would just be for the targeted people.
It would just be for the targeted people because there's just not enough time to send all 10,000 people messages. Yeah. Maybe in the future, that's
what I'm heading. Yeah. And then you'd have to answer all those 10,000 responses if they answered to you.
Right. Yeah, well, that's the part that I want to talk about was with the future was when I developed this system for not just LinkedIn, but for all the other platforms of social media, is to take in and all those people and be able to respond to all those people, not artificially, but in a way where people can know that you're paying attention to them. So there's
still personal.
I don't know how to best describe that other than we want to acknowledge each person that comes to us saying, hey, I'm very interested in connecting with you and that kind of thing. So
very cool. So how much does something like this cost? I mean, I don't want you just give us a range because you know your prices may someone may catch this podcast a year from now and your prices may be totally different.
Yeah.
But to kind of just give us an idea.
Well, for right now, the cost to be able to invest into knowing more and doing it yourself is $5,000.
Okay.
The monthly retainer that, you know, if I do it for those people, right now I'm only accepting the first 10 people that will want to do the LinkedIn automation with me the minute that I announce that I have more space and mm-hmm. more bandwidth. And then from that point, charge them $1,000 monthly retainer when I know I can provide them results. So this is a startup company and I know this works. I just need a little bit more time to be able to bring those results into more of a package deal. So when people are experiencing this and they're experiencing sales, then it's $1,000 a month retainer.
Great.
Cool. When you think of what is the value of a client to you, how much is one client worth? I mean, if you're closing 1 to 5 deals a month because of this, that's huge.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, yep. And this is just for current prices. It's going to go up very quickly here. So yeah.
I love that. Awesome. I'm writing that down. Closing 1 to 5 deals per month. I'm putting it over us just through LinkedIn.
That sounds good.
Well, Scott, tell people where they can go to find you, where they can find your book, and how they can get more information.
Sure. Well, you can look me up on Amazon, and apparently I'd love to have that link prepared, but apparently I don't know how to do that on Zoom. But
yeah, well, we can do your author page. So the best way to find his book is amazon.com/author/Scott Kaveny. Is it Scott? Is it under Scott Adam? I better double check.
Yeah, it's Scott Adam, I believe. Okay. So Scott Adam Kaveny. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we'll put that.
When you go to my website. Yep.
We'll put that in the show notes.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's Scott Adam Kaveny. And we'll put that link at the bottom so you know how to spell that. And we can get that going for you.
Terrific.
And then also you can look me up on, I have my website. So liveextraordinary.net.
liveextraordinary.net. So
and you can look up Scott on LinkedIn.
Of course.
Yep. Hurry before I close.
Before he maxes out. Yeah.
Because he has I have my other account, so you guys can connect with me up there too.
Is there a limit on LinkedIn of how many people you can
30,000.
Have? 30,000.
30,000? Yep.
35,000. I did not know
that. No, 30,000.
Oh, 30,000.
30,000.
So I've been randomly putting people. You're right. I need to be more selective because otherwise I've just got a bunch of people there that are not my customers.
Oh, yeah. That's important too.
Yeah. You want those to. I didn't know there was a limit. So, okay.
Yeah. The strategic partners and your niche, your clients, your customers, those are the people you want to connect with. Who are those strategic partners and who are those clients or customers?
Is it not very nice to like take people unconnect with them once they've connected with you, like on Facebook? Can you like clean out your LinkedIn? And
yep, there's actually a feature in the Google plugin that you can actually unconnect certain people that you don't want in your network that may not be as relevant anymore.
Yeah, Interesting. So you got to like,
so you have automation to unconnect. I love it.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, everyone. Remember to subscribe to our podcast. It has been a great show. Blow up your business with LinkedIn. Subscribe to the Elite Expert Insider podcast. Leave us a review. We'd love to hear from you. And if you're looking to become an international bestseller like Scott, contact us at eliteonlinepublishing.com. Put your submission right there, and we're happy to take a look at it and see if you qualify to work with us and become a number one best-selling author. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Thanks. Bye.
If you'd like to create the most powerful advertising tool for your business, contact us at eliteonlinepublishing.com, where we will help you create, publish, and make your book a number one bestseller and show you how to get new leads and more revenue for your business. If you'd like to check us out on our Facebook page, we have a free book for you as our gift. Just go and click free book. Remember to subscribe and leave a comment for our podcast. We would love to hear from you.